what is interesting in this project is that there are two points of view on this large topic, which is urban soundscapes. The one is very scientific, dealing with precise description with acoustic features of the sonic environments of the cities. And the other one is more musical, as Steen said, dealing with how to translate and transpose the sound of the city into a musical composition in order to describe in another way how does the city is sounding.
Yeah, I would like to add to that. The urban environment is basically a lab, right? And one is the collection of all kinds of sounds, from speech, music, machines, to animals, to nature and winds and all that stuff. But what's also very interesting is that one way to actually also engage with the city is that, in our case, we're actually viewing it as an interface. So as an interface to drive certain musical parameters as we also create music. So there's this scientific module, then there's the engineering module, then there's the artistic module, and then there's the community. So there's like four things that are intertwined. And one very important thing that we realize is the importance of the community, especially because we wanna, at the end of the day, we are creating a sound map that works in real time. And in order to have sound maps, one needs to have, at least in my opinion, a lot of sensors. There's two basic ways to go about this. One is modeling, which requires a few sensors, and models are only as good as the models are. The second is more brute force in a way, and having as many sensors as possible.